Okay, so welcome. And if it's not already done, you can find a comfortable position in which you'll spend the next hour comfortably. And I was thinking to begin this particular meditation today, simply taking a few moments to consider how lucky we are to all be here now. And all of the conditions have come together, all favorable conditions, that we can practice and we can dedicate 10 days to this wonderful practice. And this, how amazing that is, and that there is only this teaching available, and by that I mean simply the teaching of the Buddha, which is an amazing fortune, and how lucky we are to have food in our plates every day, and to live somewhere, to have a roof, four walls in Canada, heat, which is quite important, I'm sure, in Poland too. Well, I don't know. Is it warm in Poland? Yes. Okay, good.
Cold.
Cold, okay. So heat also for Poland. It's a very good thing. Good. And I know Toronto is fairly cold, so heat is good. And Quebec, well, yes, of course, that is quite the reputation. And how fortunate we are just to have all of these. And the Buddha has called these four things, having a shelter, having food, having clothing, and having access to medicine. He said these are the four basic requisites for a real Dhamma practice. These are really the minimum things that we need to be alive and well and comfortable without excess, and to practice very well. And here we are all here, and we have this, and this is really wonderful. Many, many people in the world do not have that luck, do not have this kind of blessing. And that even though we are living in fairly challenging times for a lot of people in these COVID pandemic, we still are able, because of quite interesting technology and all of these things, to get together and to actually practice together. How fortunate. And to feel grateful and perhaps even say, well, thank you life, thank you everything. And with this as a support, with this as a leverage for the meditation, whatever the meditation that you are doing right now, whether it's the metta, whether you have an object for the metta, you feel the love, however strong or subtle you feel it, that doesn't matter. If you feel it just even a tiny bit, it is great, it is wonderful. And you can bring that feeling of goodwill, of care. If you want to radiate it to all directions, or to every direction one by one, you can do so. If you're working with forgiveness, whatever comes up, if it is a stronger emotion, learn to accept it and welcome it. Be compassionate towards yourself, towards whatever that situation is, or that mental state. And if you can smile, smile. This will truly help you all the way. I often say to people that are experiencing a lot of obstacles in their meditation, if you were to only sit and smile and relax, you would already be successful. Drop by drop, the glass gets full. Whatever it is that is keeping you from experiencing love or joy, just let it go. Life is so much better with love and joy. Forgive everything that was in the past. That belongs to the past. Now is all where all the power is to change. Relax if there are any tension in your body. Break it loose, dissolve it. Relax into the love. Relax into the joy. Or the forgiveness. Whenever there is a distraction, whenever there is anything arising in the mind, even if it's anger or worry or restlessness, notice these states always come with tension, with friction. They come with discomfort. And as we learn to see this with our ever-deepening awareness, we simply let it go and release deeper and deeper, and replace that tension by a smile, by love. Whatever your practice is right now, by this time, many of you have different vehicles of meditations. You know what to do. Remember to be patient. It takes some time for the mind to settle. It doesn't happen in 5 minutes. It takes a little bit, and that's fine. We just be patient. We smile. Let go, relax. Whenever the mind becomes heavy again, it starts to go down, starts thinking about this or that, just laugh. Oh, there goes the mind again. Smile. Relax. Notice that tension that arose as this was happening. Let it go. Don't waste your time judging or thinking what it is or what your meditation should be like. It's just a hindrance, like all the other hindrances. They come with tension. We let them go. We relax. Smile into the feeling of love. Or whatever theme that you're developing right now. The mind might come up with all kinds of things. It will pull all of its tricks on you. But don't bite the hook. Just let it go. See the hook move being right in front of you, past you. And let it go. Relax. Settle and steady your mind into this boundless, loving presence. Or however you feel this love right now, simply allow your mind to rest into it. Relax, smile into it. Even if you don't believe in it, even if you don't believe in the smile, even if it feels fake, doesn't matter. Just keep smiling. You'll see. If the mind comes up with all kinds of criticism, comments about how fake it is, just laugh at it. Mind is crazy. Is that kind of mind for your own good? No. Criticizing being happy? What kind of crazy mind is that? Just let it go. Smile. These are simply things that we picked up in life from others, and we can't blame them. It just happened. Maybe we were young. Maybe we were doing something. Whatever it was. These things we just take on. And then they resonate. They stay. They leave that impression in the mind. And on this kind of practice, these things, they come up. And we get to really see all the little corners of the mind. And that is good. This is how we do the work. We clean out the closet. Every time the mind gets critical and cynical and skeptical, just laugh at it. See what that does. Come back to the love, come back to the joy. Boundlessly, or however you can. You cannot fail. You can only do it. And however you're going to do it, it's good. Continue. And perhaps some of you are experiencing that the metta is calming down, and the mind is becoming very steady, very collected, and that becomes the main experience, collectedness. Perhaps you notice body, but it seems a bit distant and not very prominent. It is slowly fading, like something that's just happening in the background. Very good. And that the metta is slowly calming down, and slowly, slowly there remains only some remnants of it as the mind becomes very steady, very happy, very collected. Perhaps noticing that mind feels like spacious, it feels vast. And the metta kind of changes slightly, becomes a little more distant. That's very normal. And slowly joy starts to be more predominant. Very simple joy. Radiant joy. Piti bhakkhaṃ bhavissāma. Feeders on joy we shall be. Deva abhasarayata. Like the devas of streaming radiance. And as we move further along in this retreat, we will notice that the mind will need more time now to settle and experience deeper states of meditation. So progressively, keep sitting, keep meditating a little bit more each time. 1 hour, 2 hours, however it feels comfortable. Even 3 or 4 hours for the later stages will be necessary. But slowly, incrementally, at your own pace. And also listen to what feels right to you. Listen to your intuition. And have a very fruitful, happy, uplifted meditation. Bhavatu sabba mangalang rakkhantu sabba devata sabba buddhanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te bhavatu sabba mangalang rakkhantu sabba devata sabba dhammanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te Bhavatu sabba mangalang rakkhantu sabba devata sabba sanghanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te. May all blessings be with you, and may all the devas protect you by the powers of all the Buddhas, the Dhamma and the Sangha. May you be well and happy. Sigh.